Hi, I'm Michael.
I'm Alex.
At Pride Roofing, we handle commercial and residential work.
TPO, shingle and metal inventory.
We got it. Property still in disarray from the recent hurricanes and hailstorms. Insurance claims?
No problem.
Call 855-PRIDE-16. Se habla Espanol.
Assessor Jeff Taylor was on hand here at Greystone Country Club when Liz Merle, the state's Solicitor General, but also a leading candidate now in the runoff for Attorney General, spoke to a very enthusiastic crowd. And you know, what I see is that it's not a Republican takeover. It is a very conservative Republican takeover that we're witnessing in Louisiana. Would you agree?
I would absolutely agree. It's not, like you said, it's not just Republican. We've had Republicans in charge before, but this is a conservative movement. And so being one of the first, or the first, parish-wide elected official in Livingston Parish 20 years ago, that is a big change from what it was. And so you're seeing that our state is more and more conservative. Our parish is very conservative. You see with all the council races and with the representative and Senate races and everything, we're looking for people that are conservative, that want to do the things that we believe in out here.
Well, if there is a menu or an agenda in this new takeover, maybe it was stated today when Liz Merle spoke about crime, the number one issue, then insurance, then curbing the powers of the governor to declare an emergency that will last for years, maybe forever, which is what we saw during COVID.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's the big thing. Crime. We don't want all the crime and everything out here. It's coming. As more and more people move in here, the crime is going to come. So we want to have smart development. We want to have things that happen in our parish to where when people come out here, we're not building just little cookie cutter subdivisions. We want to make sure that we're taking care of these people are our neighbors. We need to take care of people that were here in Livingston already. We need to make sure that they're taken well care of. We want to be welcoming to everybody, but we want to make sure that what they're coming into is something that's good. And then when you get into just the curbing of everything else, we are a conservative community. And so we want to make sure that when you come here, that education is there. We want to make sure that we have the schools. We want to make sure we have the roads. We'll make sure that we're doing smart government. We'll make sure that when we have homes that come in here, that the assessments are correct.
So you did not have a race this year. Congratulations, you had no opponent. But a lot of assessors did. And one question that it comes up all the time, and maybe you can help answer it. When you get on the internet now, as you can do, and you check and see the assessments of a neighborhood, and people say, well, gosh, my neighbor has a house twice as big as mine, but he's paying less than I am in property taxes. How do you explain these anomalies that seem to appear on all the rolls?
Well, it's a bunch of different things that goes into it. Age of the house, quality of the house, all of those things go into it. A lot of times people want to say, well, my house is the same size, but he does have one less room than I do. Well, it's not the same size. A lot of people want to look across the deal and think that, okay, everything is on an even par. But if you got a house that was built 20 years ago versus one that was built 2 years ago, there's going to be a difference in assessment. But you said something very interesting there. I was helped lead way back in 2000. We led the effort to make sure that we put the assessments on the roll, on the internet. And the reason for that is because I wanted people to call us and tell us, because we've only got a limited staff. And when you're looking at Livingston Parish, it's going to take forever to put a tape measure on all the houses. So there was people that was never being reassessed with old numbers. But when people all of a sudden started calling and saying, wait a minute, this house is the same as mine. We have the same square footage. Everything is the same. His assessment is way lower. We wanted to take a look at them. And we're down now, Ken, to less than 400 structures in the parish that have not had a tape measure put on. It took us 12 to 13 years to make that happen because of our staffing. But we have got it now to where when we say that this is how many square feet, this is how many square feet you have. And we're very proud of that. So it's making the assessments a lot fairer.
One thing also I noticed, and this is true in all parishes, once a year you can get a chance to go to the parish council and complain about your assessments. There is a higher power to go to, and if you don't like what the parish council says, you can go to the state level. But most of the time, here in Livingston, for example, nobody shows up to complain.
No, nobody shows up to complain. They complain, but they do it on Facebook and internet and things like that. But a lot of times when people come into our office, when we present to them, this is how our numbers are come to. You can go get an appraisal. You can dispute our deal. You can go to the parish council. You can go to the tax commission. But the truth of the matter is when they come into our office and we lay it out there for them, we don't willy-nilly this thing. We actually go out there and we have a scientific method that we use for assessing property. And when you look at it and you look at how we came up with that number, you really don't have an argument. That's why we don't have very many appeals.
Would you agree that I think we're seeing with the defeat of a school board millage and also a defeat of the renewal of the health unit millage, I think there's sort of a taxpayer revolt brewing here in Livingston Parish.
Oh, absolutely. We were talking about that earlier this morning with some people here. You see the recreation district up in Watson. They have a very good recreation district. They have a very good school system up in Watson. But you're starting to see people start to revolt against some of the taxes. The health unit. So we're getting ourselves into almost into a anti-tax. And so I tell people all the time, I don't vote against taxes just to vote against the tax. I want to see what's being done with that money. And if you can show me where that money is being used efficiently, I'm going to support that tax. But if you cannot, then I'm not going to support that tax. I've also started working, Ken, on the prospect of doing a millage meeting. Instead of having 40-something millage meetings where all these districts can have a millage on a different night, because there's no way for you to get to all of them. But if we do a common meeting, and I've talked to some of the new councilmen, I'm having a meeting when they have the runoff, and we know who the nine are going to be, I'm going to bring them over to the office. I'm going to show them what my office does, how we don't get involved in any of the business with the parish. We work millages and we work assessments. That's what our job is. And then I'm going to show them that if we would work with the people and have one common meeting to where everybody could come in and at one night we could show them what our millages are going to be, why the assessor is going to charge this many mills, why the sheriff's office, why the school board, why the drainage district. And you can do that in one night, and then 30 days later come back and vote on what you're going to do in millages, and you do it in front of the people, you're going to see some of the millages change.
By the way, you know, doesn't it make sense? When a taxpayer pays a bill, they're not going to minutely go down and look at all 40 designations. I mean, the problem in Livingston, you said traditionally, has been that the average homeowner here just pays too much.
Yeah. Well, what they do is the millages, when they're set, they want to, if they do a 10-mill tax, they say, well, the voters voted for us to have 10 mills. Not necessarily. What you do is you ask for this much money. You ask for $1 million. I tell you it's going to take you 10 mills to get that. Well, the next year, when I do my job as assessing and that number goes up to 1.1 million, you should adjust your millages down. Nobody is saying that you shouldn't take inflation, but nobody should take these windfalls that we're having. We have a high millage, and it's because our districts won't lower their millages. Not all of them can. No, I never ask our school board and our fire departments and our sheriff's office, because they need the money to do this. But some of our districts can lower the millages. I know I can. I lower mine every year.
By the way, you know, the public may not agree with you that there are millages that can't be touched. Look at the health unit.
Yeah, absolutely. You look at that, but people are starting to say, we've had enough. We've had enough of this, and every time you turn around, there's a different tax here, a different tax there. I've supported some. I've been against some. But when you really start looking at it, if you're not lowering your millages some, we've got a reassessment next year. We've got properties that are going to be going up 40%. 40%. Not all of them, but some of them are, because they rebuild after the flood and this is the first reassessment they've had. Well, when you're looking at that, don't tell me you can't lower your millages some, because if you made it this year, you can make it next year with just a cost of inflation.
One thing that occurs to me is that if the parish continues with these building moratoriums or very strict controls, there'll be fewer homes built. But on the other hand, the ones we already have, their value will skyrocket. Good thing for selling your house, right? But not good when you pay your tax bill.
It's not good when you pay your tax bill unless people lower their millages. If they lower their millages, do you realize that your tax bill should not change from year to year? It is all based off of millages. If they would lower their millages to what they're supposed to do, your tax bill don't change. A lot of people blame the assessor for the taxes. I do zero with your taxes. I put an assessment. I tell you what the value of your house is. If I put a value of $100,000 on a home and there is zero mills passed, your tax bill is zero. But if I put your value of your house at $1 and there's 100 mills out there, you pay a tax. So people have it backwards. And we've tried to educate them that the assessor does nothing with your taxes. All I do is assess the value of your property.
What else are you working on?
We're working on some updating our mapping system. We're working on that. We've got it in-house now. We had GCT working. We're doing some traveling. I'm taking some of my leadership to different areas. One of the ones is we're going to go to Vermont. We're going to go try to work on this sequestration with some of the different states, because whether you agree with the sequestration or not, if it comes here, I got to be ready to know how to tax it. You know, I not assess it, not tax it, but I got to be ready to know how to do that. I don't need to be waiting around saying, oh, I should have done this 2 years ago. So we're going ahead and starting to do some of that research. We're going to Vermont on some software issues to look and see what they've got. They also went through a big flood a few years ago. I want to see how they're progressing in their assessments of their flood, because we had a big flood, and I want to make sure that we're all on even keel. We kind of stay in touch with, I'm a member of the International Association, so I kind of stay in touch with different assessors districts around. And so we're going to be doing, over this next year, year and a half, we're going to do a lot of traveling to see. I know what people in Louisiana do. I know what all the assessors, I meet with them 5, 6, 7 times a year. I want to find out what the new best thing is that I can bring back to Livingston Parish, because you know what? We deserve the best. We deserve officials that are going to give their best. We deserve officials that know what they're doing, and we need to know the officials that know what other people are doing.
Travel back in time to experience the Middle Ages at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. Explore the English village of Albright at the height of the 16th century and enjoy jousting tournaments, dueling, juggling, magic, and falconry. Meet the Queen. Experience the charms of musical minstrels. See real blacksmiths, glass blowers, candle makers, and so much more. And shop for fantastic and unique items you can't find anywhere else. The Louisiana Renaissance Festival.